spokesperson, Dr. Vignesh, for immediately accepting our invitation to conduct this particular program for SALIS member. Of course, we have also admitted many other our library young professionals also across India. So thank you very much, sir, for immediately accepting our invitation. And I would like to give you a brief introduction about Mr. Vignesh. Mr. Vignesh is currently the Chief Strategic and Outreach Officer at the NDLI. And he is also the founder of a brilliant IAS preparer, a mobile-based low-costing training solution for the civil service aspirant. Earlier to this, he worked with the Indian Public Library Movement and CSE E-Governance Service India Limited. And he has already managed and involved in many projects like, you know, that NDLMI, National Digital Literacy Mission, Cybercrime Yojana, E-Inclusion, IT Training for Rural SCST Women, FENVISADI, E-Vithya, that is a project, an innovative project for rural women and women literacy project, Child Labor Family Linkage Project, Financial Literacy and Investor Awareness, Legal Literacy, Tele-Ophthalmology, and various other projects involved. And actually, he did all his bachelor degree and thing from Tamil Nadu, and then he did his PG and as well as PhD from Jain University with a Master's in Public Management. He has been actively participating in various international forums like International General Agreement on ICT 4D, Internet Government Forum, EESA, and many more he has involved. And as a young age, actually, he has involved in many other projects. And these are the projects, if you deeply look into it, is somewhat related to library and information science. And thank you once again, Dr. Vignesh sir, for having accepted your invitation. Thank you once again. And we continue to collaborate with you after this corona. We'll conduct Charlie's and NTLA conduct many more such programs in many places in the country. Thank you very much, sir. Please continue. Okay. Thank you, sir.
So thank you to Dr. Harigaran. Sir, could you put your mic on mute? So I'm muted. Okay, so thanks to Dr. Harigaran and Salish for inviting us to conduct a session for Salish members. Good morning, everyone. As Dr. Harigaran mentioned, my name is Vignesh. I'm part of the National Digital Library of India team. And I could see from the names, few familiar names. So I'm happy to see them here. Dr. Arumugam, Dr. Senthil Kumar. So thanks for attending this session. So before we get into the meeting, I wanted to give you a brief background about why NDLI, where it started, and how do we use the resources, what is it? So gradually we will move on. So let me begin with the idea of NDLI. So the idea of NDLI came into being, I think, towards the end of 2015. So when the centrally funded institutions like IITs, IIMs, they approach every year for the Ministry of Human Resource Development for getting their budget approved. So almost all the institutions had a budget of, say, 20 to 25 crore rupees for their libraries. And all of them proposed to procure a same set of resources from the same set of publishers, almost similar. And so that then HRD minister asked a question like, why are we buying the same resources from the same vendor at different cost? And why can't we procure a national license and host it in a centralized repository? So that is when, and she also asked another question like, so we give you resources for procuring resources. And what about those small institutions where the budget is less? So she muted this idea of collaborating, coming up with a platform where we can share resources and collate and integrate resources. That's when the idea of NDLI came in. So IIT Kharagpur, led by Professor Partha Pradeem Chakraborty and Dr. Professor Partha Pradeem Das, they got this idea and then they developed a concept note, and then they had a first round of discussion with MHRD. And thanks to the dynamic leadership of the then officials, and they immediately grabbed onto this proposal and they supported it. So NDLI was started as a pilot project in 2016, as many of you would know. The objective is to basically create an integrating platform wherein we collaborate and collate resources which are non-copyrighted open knowledge resources. So that's the idea to begin with. So we looked around. When we started, we had very less content. We had very few users. And then gradually MHRD pushed it through its own official channels, through UGC, AACT, NAC, NAB. So all these were pushed. And then immediately we started getting good number of response from the institutions. So what happened was, like, in this process, the key objective of NDLI, which is to take forward the resources to the end beneficiaries, has not happened. So it all went like a top-down approach when everybody pushed the registration without showing the value what NDLI is and what is the way of taking forward these resources. So that is when our first challenge came in. So when we had a review of our program a couple of years back, we realized we had 50 lakh registered users, but only 22 lakh users who are actually activated and using the account. So then we introspected, we looked at the reasons. The main reason was we didn't show them the value of NDLI to the first, to the stakeholders, that is the library professionals, the principals, the faculty members, and the students. We never touched all the points. So that's when we started looking at conducting various workshops, awareness sessions, and then we started looking at having NDLI clubs in various institutions. So this is the background with which NDLI started. And now let us look at the presentation. Is this presentation visible to all of you? Okay. Is this visible, sir, Dr. Hariharan?
Yes, yes.
Clearly. Okay, so I'm moving ahead. So, just give me a moment, I'm just arranging a few things. So, as of yesterday, we have closer to 4.78 crore resources in 300 languages from 251 resources with about 55 lakh registered users. So what is the perspective of NDLI? So India as a country is turning every month, at least 10 lakh people are turning into an age of 18, which means they are getting into the higher educational stream. So looking at the current statistics of existing educational institutions, so India needs at least 6 universities and 270 colleges every month to bridge the educational divide. So not in very like one location, or it has to be spread across the country. So if you look at Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, Telangana, the West Bengal. So these states, the number of educational institutions are very less compared to the southern states, especially Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh. Here the number of institutions are slightly higher. So if you look at like addressing this educational so I just wanted to ask Mr. Kuttikumar, are you able to see the slideshow? Because everybody else is able to see, and also Naheem KT. Okay, let me just see. But Let me restart the screen again and then we will start this. Is it visible now? Okay, so some of you have said yes, so I'm moving ahead. So for people who have not been able to see, I will share this presentation after the meeting is over. So you can keep this presentation handy. I think maybe you have some connectivity issue, that's why you're not able to see the presentation. So anyways, I will move on. So India needs 6 universities and 270 colleges if you have to address the educational divide. So that if we translate that into an investment perspective, India needs to invest anywhere between 60,000 crore to 1 lakh crore every month to address this gap. And this is just a one-time investment cost. So imagine the kind of operational cost that would require. So it will range anywhere between another 60,000 crore to 1 lakh crore to address this gap. But the real question is, even if we invest 60,000 crore rupees or 1 lakh crore rupees, are they sustainable? So we don't have an answer to it. So the government of India looked at alternative solutions which can address the digital divide. So that's when they started looking at various digital learning platforms which can supplement and complement the physical infrastructure. So like NPTEL, Swayam, Swayam Prabha, NDLA, these are all supplementary and complementary learning platforms which supplement the education existing system. So NDLA was formally dedicated to the nation on the 19th of June 2018 by the then MHRD minister. So what do we have at NDLA? At NDLA, we primarily ingest metadata. We only have metadata in our platform. Why? For a simple reason, that the reason is we don't want to get into the copyright violation issue. So many of you have known about the Digital Library of India initiative and what happened to it after the Supreme Court verdict. So it has to close down. So for that purpose, so we are hosting only metadata because at this point in time, metadata is non-copyrighted at this point in time only. So we are allowed to host metadata in our repository. So we have we primarily have metadata, and you may ask, where is the full text? So the full text actually comes from our partners. Say for example, IIT Mumbai is our partner, and the full text is lying with them. We basically ingest the metadata from their IDR to our repository. So that is how it works. So anybody who wants to access the full text, we actually redirect them to the partner's website. So that's the reason. And then the use model, how have we designed this entire platform is. So we basically collaborate with content contributors, right? So for example, if Salis as an institution has a repository of say 10,000 resources, which are digitized and non-copyrighted and open resources, then what we do is we help them in creating an IDR, institutional digital repository. And then we ingest the metadata only. We ingest metadata into our platform, and then we harvest the metadata. And then we give front-end access to the various stakeholders who are like researchers, students, learners, professionals, anybody who is interested in learning. So we actually act as a repository of knowledge resources. So what type of content we have at NDLA? So we have three types of content. One is born digital object. That means, say for example, you have typed your thesis in a computer and then you have converted this into a Word and then PDF, and then you did it in a CD or a pen drive and gave it to your college or university for uploading. at the time of submission, right? So what happens is, like, the university further submits that resources to InfibNet Shodganga, and then it becomes a national repository. So what happens is, the content is actually typed and converted into a digital format. So it is in bound digital. It's called bound digital object. And the second one is digital surrogate of a physical object. That means, say, for example, there was a thesis which was typed using a typewriter, say, 20 years back. And then now you need to convert it into a digital resource. How do we do it? We actually scan it, digitize it, and then put it as a PDF. So that is called digital surrogate of a physical object. And the third one is, we only have metadata of the physical object. So these are the three types of content we have at NDLI. So as of now, we have closer to 251 content contributors. So you name any major educational or research institutions, they are all part of the NDLI ecosystem. So this is as per DDC. So you can see the type of content that is available. So computer science, information and general works, we have closer to 99 lakhs. Philosophy and psychology, we have 5 lakhs. Religion, we have 2 lakhs. Social sciences, we have 45 lakhs. Language, we have 1 lakh. Natural sciences and mathematics, 83 lakhs. Technology, 1 crore. Arts and fine and decorative arts, 4.5 lakhs. Literature and rhetorics, 1.8 lakhs. History and geography, 6.1 lakhs. So this is the type of content resources we have. So who are the top 20 content contributors? So you can see World eBook Library, CiteCRX, PubMed Central, IEEE Explore Digital Library, WHO, Global Index Medicus, Director of Open Access Channel, Semantic Scholar, Springer Link, Paperity. So here I wanted to say, Government of India has procured a national license from World eBook Library and also from South Asia Archives. So which means, like, the Government of India has procured the subscription of World Book Library and South Asia Archives on behalf of the Indian citizens. So for Indian citizens who are registered at NDLI, it's completely free for them. Say, for example, South Asia Archives, which was available before NDLI with only three institutions, JNU, Jadavpur University and Allahabad University. JNU bought it for, I think, around 1.5 crore or something. And then Jadavpur is around 1 crore. And then Allahabad University bought it for 75 lakh rupees. Now, that is for one institution subscription fee. And the entire South Asia Archives is available at NDLI at free of cost. And similarly, World eBook Library, I think all of you might know about Dellnet. So majority of the resources come from World eBook Library. You may be paying anywhere between, 25,000 to 45,000 rupees subscription fee every year to Dellnet to take their subscription. So that is also coming under World eBook. That is also available at NDLI at free of cost. Then what type of content, range of content that we have is, like, you name a book, a thesis, a dissertation, a temp paper, video lecture, audio lecture, data sets, maps, manuscripts, question banks. You name any form of learning or educational related resources, it's available at NDLI. And what type of content dominates the list? Article is the major chunk of the content that we have. 2.95 crore resources are articles. 63 lakh resources are books. And 12 lakh are reports. 11 lakh are notes. Law acts are about 8 lakhs. Law judgments are about 8.7 lakhs. Technical reports are 7 lakh. Thesis is about 6.4 lakhs. Historical record is about 5.33. Video lectures is about 3.61 lakhs. And if you ask me, access rights-wise content, so we have open and NDLI are full-text resources, right? So we have closer to 3.6 crore resources as full-text resources. That means 75% of our resources are full-text. So the remaining 25% may be coming from, say, IEEE, Springer. So they have only shared the metadata. They have not given access to their full text. However, the government of India is seriously considering of procuring national licenses from many important such players as well. And who is this for? So NDLI is for every segment of the society, starting from school going students to youths, college going youths, professionals, academicians and researchers, entrepreneurs, or lifelong learners. It's meant for everyone who is interested in learning. Now let us see how to access NDLI. So if you have your mobile phone, or if you have access to your desktop, you can also learn by doing it as well. So simple, how do we access? You go to any browser. So here I have used Google. So you can use Google or any other browser. Say your mobile phone, you can use any browser, or just type National Digital Library of India. The first URL which you will get is ndl.iitkgp.ac.in or ndl.gov.in. So these are the two URLs. So both of them works, and you can click on any one of them and you will be redirected to our homepage. So this is how our current homepage looks like. Once you log in, this pop-up window also opens. So I will talk about this NDLI Edcorona Outreach pop-up very shortly. So this is how our homepage looks like. And then for searching, you have a search bar. So using NDLI is very simple. Okay. You need to know only very few things. First, you need to know how to search. Click on the search and then your search box appears. You just type the search keyword. Here I've typed history of English literature. Remember, you need to type it without any spelling mistake. So many of the, like I might have conducted around 60-70 workshops, and only a major mistake people do is the spelling mistake of this keyword. So kindly remember the spelling mistake. Kindly remember the spelling and then type it properly. And then click search. Okay. And then the results will appear. Now what you can do is you can actually filter the resources based on these 7 or 8 filters that are useful. So here I have, what I have done is subject category, language and literature. I have clicked 2 subjects and I got 6.74 lakh resources on history of English literature. And the second just give me a moment. And the second search I made is on modern India. So here I applied 2 filters. One is access restriction, wherein I wanted only full text resource. So what I did was I clicked on open and NDLI access restriction filter, and then subject category history and geography. So I got 20,000 results on modern India. And the third search term is called Indian constitutional law. So I went to access restriction. I want only full text. So I clicked open and NDLI. I got 31 lakh resources on Indian constitutional law. So if I have to further narrow it down, what I can do is I can go to source and then I can click on Indian Law Institute. Then I will get only resources from Indian Law Institute. And the next topic I searched was banking law, and I wanted only from the subject category of social science. I got 14 lakh resources on banking law. And the next topic I searched was 1984, which is one of the top 10 famous novels in the world, written by George Orwell. So we have full text of George Orwell resources from NDLI. And then I searched for a term called sociology, and I wanted only video lectures. So what I did was I entered sociology, clicked search, and then on the right hand side, I have a filter called content type. Video. So here I wanted only video lectures. So I clicked on video and I got 455 video lectures on sociology. And the next topic I searched was from microeconomics. And here I wanted it from the source of MIT OpenCourseWare and Asim Premji Foundation. So I got 251 results on microeconomics from Asim Premji Foundation and MIT OpenCourseWare. And then I searched for a term called human physiology, and I wanted only video lectures. And you know how to do it. Go to content type, click on video, you get video lectures. So I got 12,788 video lectures on human physiology. Here, if you want to narrow down it to your subject, go to subject category and then click on natural sciences. You will get specific resources. So next topic I searched for us on engineering mechanics. Okay. And I wanted it from a specific author called Sudarshan Iyengar. So I clicked on Iyengar Sudarshan. I got 862 results on engineering mechanics from the author of Sudarshan Iyengar. And the next topic I searched was on artificial intelligence. Okay. Here I applied three filters. The first filter is I clicked it from open resources, and then subject category of computer science and technology. And I wanted other resources from MIT OpenCourseWare. So I got all the 364 results I received. And the next topic I searched was on effective parenting. Here I wanted it in the file format of an MP3 file, which is an audio file. So I went to file format filter and then I clicked on MP3 only. I got 6,500 results on resources on effective parenting. And then I searched for a term called pedagogy from Pertha Payne. I got 8 results. And then I searched for a term called rural marketing. I wanted only full text, so I clicked open and NDLI. I got 6.3 lakh resources on open and NDLI only. Okay, so this is what I told you when we started. So during this time of lockdown, our team has actually further classified the resources as per educational level and then discipline as well. So what they have done is classified. So if you want to access that, what you need to do is go to homepage. On the homepage top bar, you will see an icon called Corona Outbreak : Study from Home. Okay. Once you click this pop-up window appears. So you can click on, if you want to resources from school, you just click on school. You will get resources from school, UG Engineering, UG Science, UG Other Disciplines, Language, Management, Law. So you accordingly choose your discipline. And I just wanted to remind you, our team is still populating it. We have just done the first level of work and it is being further classified. So here what I clicked is UG Engineering, and then this is how the tabs looks like. So I got common subjects, aerospace engineering, architecture, chemical engineering, civil engineering, computer science engineering, electrical engineering, electronics, mechanical, mining, ocean, textile engineering. Okay, now let us see how to open a resource. Okay, so here I search for a term called human resource management. Okay, and if I want to open this first resource, so what do I do have to do is click on this human resource, click on this topic title. So this is how the page opens. So there are two tabs on the left top corner. So one is called content, another one is called metadata. So you first click on the metadata and then you will see the title. What is metadata? Metadata is nothing but data about data. In crude way, you can put it as basic information about a resource. So here the title is human resource management. Author is Gary Roberts. Source is World eBook Library. Content type is text, file format is PDF, and you can see all the other information here. And this access restriction is NDLI, which means it's a full text resource. So this is free for people who are registered at NDLI. Suppose if you have not logged in, this tab may not open. So here there will be a tab called log in to view or download content. So you have to click there, and then suppose if you have not logged in and if you are already registered, you just have to enter your username and password and log in. Suppose if you have not registered at NDLI, on the same where the same place, you will have an option called sign up or register. Click register or sign up. You will have to fill a small registration form. Fill that form, submit. You will get a verification email. Just verify that email. So you, then you can log in with your username and password, and then you can download it by clicking on the content. So here, suppose if I click content, you will get the entire full text of this content. Suppose if it's a video lecture, this is how the video lecture will display. So basically, I want to inform you, using NDLI is very simple, provided you know very few things. One is know the exact search topic and where to type without any spelling mistake. And the next is filters. You should remember some of the filters which are important. So here I'm going to talk about only the important filters. First is access restriction. So you click on, suppose if you want only full text resources, just click on open and NDLI, you will get only full text resources. And the second filter is on author. You choose the author which you were which you want, you then you will get the resources from the corresponding author only. And the third one is subject category. This is as per DDC classification. So you should know the DDC classification subjects so that you can correctly choose the resources. And the other next important filter is learning resource type. Which type of content you want, whether you want an audiobook or a book review or a booklet, case study, newspaper, periodical, or a book or a video lecture. So you can choose from here. And the next important filter is source, from whom you want the content from. Okay. And on the right hand side, you will see a content type filter through which you can actually choose, filter down the content based on the content type. So I just wanted to say a few things. One is that educational degree, educational level, and difficulty level. These three filters, our team is still working, because when we collaborated with the partners, they have not classified the content as per the educational level or these three filters. So we may have some difficulty in classifying this. So I request you to use access restriction, author, subject category, file format, language, learning resource type, and source. So these filters work better, and these three filters have some minor technical bug. And also we have the entire interface, language interface, in some of the Indian languages. Those are Hindi, Bangla, Gujarati, Kannada, Marathi, Oriya, and Tamil. Okay. And it is also under being developed in other Indian languages as well, apart from English. And also for the young users, we also have come up with a mobile app for this program. We have the mobile app for both Android as well as iOS. So you can download the app from Play Store as well as from My Store. So now I will tell you how to use the Android mobile app. So this is how the Android homepage looks like. Suppose if you want to search, so how you have to do is click on this search icon. You just have to click, and then this search box appears. Okay, enter the search keyword, and then the list, the resources display here. Suppose if you want to filter the resources, you just have to click on this orange color icon. So this is the filter icon in the mobile app. Whereas in the desktop, you will see it on the left hand side, on the right hand side. Here it is available on the right bottom corner. And then once you click, all the filters which we saw in the desktop application is available on the top. So basically you can scroll the filters. Here I applied for a source called Aligarh Muslim University, and then I click on apply. Then I got 199 results on Uttar Pradesh from the source of Aligarh Muslim University. So this is how you have to use the mobile app. Okay, so before we move on to the next slide, I wanted to take a quick pause. I'm going to take 5 minutes of your time, and I'm going to request all of you to kindly download NDLI mobile app and then search for the terms which are relevant for your institution, and then see whether it is useful or not. Once you are done, kindly send me a text chat message on the using the chat option. Put whether it's you have downloaded it, and then whether you find it useful for now. So now it's 12:06 in my desktop. So take 5 minutes. We will come back by 12:11. And till that time, I'm going to mute my mic and then mute my video. And I'm muting Dr. Hariharan. If you want to give some instructions to the participants, kindly do so. And I'm just muting my mic and the video.
No, actually, they are supposed to install and come back again. Hello?
Yes, sir. So I kindly request them to install the NDLI mobile app and then search for the topics which are relevant to their institution, and then come back in 5 minutes.
So again, they have to rejoin or let it be here?
No, let them be here. They don't have to leave the group. Okay.
Okay. Oh, thank you, participant. I think just like you can see, it's a kind of exercise. Kindly download the mobile app. Maybe you can visit the Google Play Store, then download it. And give a search, you know, using your field of interest, get some result, and then you will get some idea, then you can join again. Thank you.
Mr. Kutikumar, I am just checking my mobile app. Let me see if there is some issue in the app. But it's working in my mobile, and I can also search for. And it's working perfectly, Mr. Kutikumar. I think there is something wrong with your mobile, or you have not installed it properly. I think for others it's working. Okay, so should we start?
Yes, sir, we can start actually by the time.
Yeah. So I think
yes, maybe after this session also they can
So
do it actually.
I will restart the presentation. Okay, so kindly let me know whether the presentation is visible in your app, in your system.
Yes.
Okay, so I'm moving ahead.
Can respond.
Yes, it is visible, Mr. Ramasam. Thank you, Mr. Ramasam. So now we will get back into the session. So now let us see the major difference between Google and NDLI. So Google is a giant, and we don't have any competition with Google, and Google does its job brilliantly. Okay. And we are going to just see some slight difference between Google and NDLI. So imagine there is a girl called Payal who is studying in class 8, and she is from Hindi medium, and Shamik who wants to pursue his PhD, and he also interested in learning about magnetism. So what they did is they both went to Google and they searched for a topic called magnetism, and they got 2.49 crore results. Okay. And then they came to NDLI and they searched for the term called magnetism, and they got 4.19 lakh results. And what Payal did is she applied filters called educational level 5th through 8th standard and then language of Hindi. She got 56 results, whereas what Samik did was he wanted only career or technical papers, and he got 219 results. So imagine from 2.4 crore to 219. So this is the major thing. So what Google does is, Google, the moment you put a keyword, it searches the entire world wide web, and wherever this term is there, it fetches the results. So Google can't distinguish whether it's from an authentic source or an unauthentic source, whether the information is correct or fake, whether it is reliable or unreliable. So Google can't give you any assurance on these aspects. Whereas at NDLI, we depend on our partners for content, and we partner with institutions which are reputed institutions, and we ensure that all these resources are curated and they are primarily meant for educational purposes only. So that's the major difference. We don't have any unwanted resources in our database. And then second difference is we have filter options, which is not available with Google. So we can actually filter down using 7 or 8 filters, which are useful in narrowing our research. And then third one is important one is the national licensing. The government of India has procured national licensing from few institutions, and it is in the process of looking at procuring resource licenses from other major publishers as well. And today we have closer to 22,000 partnering institutions who are like institutional partners, and we have 55 lakh registered users, out of which 23 lakh of them are very active, and 11 lakh mobile app downloads. And we during this time of Corona, our usage has drastically increased from a few thousands to few lakhs. So that is the power. And what is the big picture? So the big picture is maybe over a period of 5 years or 10 years, the already we have the credit transfer and virtual certification system, which is like if you augment a course from Swayamprabha or NPTEL, you can transfer the credit of 20, up to 20 credits to your coursework. That is already there. And so maybe 5 years or 10 years down the lane, if you have the interest to learn and if you have a mobile phone or a desktop and the internet connected, you can actually learn from obtain a certificate or a diploma or UG and PG over internet. So that is, that may be possible over a period of time. And NDLA is also a supplementary learning resource that is available. Now let us see the purpose of NDLA club. So as I mentioned, we have sent the circular, but majority of the institutions, so I might have interacted with at least some 200-300 principals in the last couple of years. So they've all heard about NDLA, but they have never used it. They've heard, they've got a circular, and as soon as they got a circular, they read it and then they forwarded it to the librarian for doing the needful. And what happened to the librarian is he saw the circular, he saw the website, he found it okay, and then he put it on the poster, notice board for people to see and use. And then the faculty members, some of them hardly go to the libraries, and the students, you know how frequent they are to the libraries. So what happened is in this process, it has not actually gone down well to the faculty and the student community. So what we propose to various stakeholders is start a NDLA club in your own educational institution and promote the culture of reading. So that is where the starting point should start. See, unless and until we have the culture of reading, we whatever resource we have, it will not be of any use to anyone. So for that, we thought the NDLA club could be one of the ways to start. There may be multiple ways, and NDLA club is just one of the ways to reach the ultimate end of create the culture of reading. So what we propose under this NDLA club is at least one student from every class and one faculty member from each department, with librarian as the ex officio secretary and principal as the ex officio chairman of the club. Okay. And then you get this list prepared and then approved by the head of the institution. And then you apply for a NDLA club registration. So this is where the club publication form is available. And this is the form that you may come across. You just have to fill the basic details about your institution and then attach the file of NDLA club members, which was approved by your head of the institution, and then tentative date of starting the club, and then submit. We review this application and then we issue a certificate of registration that is valid for 1 year. So within that 1 year, what you need to do is you have to register most of your faculties and students under NDLA. And how will you do it? The thing is, like, you have at least one student from each class and one faculty member from each department. And what you can do is you first conduct an awareness session for your own NDLA club members, and the NDLA club members in turn go back to their classes and the departments and create an awareness about it to their fellow colleagues or students. And you collect, you can do a bulk registration or individual registration. And now let us see how to do the bulk registration. So once you conduct the awareness session for the students and the faculty members, you collect three details from each one of them. First is their personal email ID. I repeat, personal email ID, because many of the institutions have put their official email IDs, which may be deleted after 4 years or 3 years after they pass out of the college. Once they pass out, they don't access that email ID, and which will ultimately result in unusage of NDLA. So ultimately the objective is to create it as a lifelong learning resource. So we request you to collect their personal email ID. Collect personal email ID, first name and last name in this Excel sheet. This is how the format looks like. Just collect it without any heading or without any numbering. You just have to put all these three details and then save it as an Excel format or a CSV file. And then you have to send it to this email ID, ndl-support@iitkgp.ac.in, with basic details of your institution. And mark a copy to my email ID, which is vignesh@ndl.gov.in, or my personal email ID, vigneshjnu@gmail.com. So you can send this list, and then we do a bulk registration of the list which you have sent, and they will get a verification email in their email. Okay. And you have to ask them to click that URL, and we will give you a temporary password. Just put the temporary password, and then they will be prompted to create a new password and then set to go. Right. And some of them may not get an automated email, or it may be in their junk box. So what you can do is, on the homepage, we have an option called account recovery. So just put their email ID, and the verification email will be generated once again, and then they can activate their account. The most important part, the pain point, is you collect the email ID, we send the email, but most of them don't activate their account. So to avoid this, some of the institutions have come up with some innovative ideas. One of them is, after the bulk registration is done, they call them by department wise or class wise, either to the library if there are good number of computers, or to the computer lab. The librarian takes a awareness session and make sure that everybody gets the username, and they log into the system, and they are made aware of how to use the NDLA website as well as the mobile app. So that is a better way of doing it. Anyways, you will be doing an awareness session, like library awareness session or library introduction session to all the new joinees. So during that time itself, if you do this, this is a helpful exercise. And for individual registration, the process is very simple. Say, for example, if you want to create an account for your family members or friends, just go to NDLA homepage. On the homepage, right bottom corner, you will see a register icon. Just click on this icon. This is how the application form, registration form looks like. Just enter the full name, email ID, password, confirm password. These are the mandatory details. Rest of them are optional. And then you submit. You get a verification email. Just click on that URL and you are all set to go. You can log in with your username and password. Okay, so this is the first exercise that you need to complete. That is, you need to register all your members, students and faculty members, within 30 days of getting the club's registration certificate. And the second most important part is, conduct at least 10 reading or knowledge related activities within the next 12 months. What are those activities that you may conduct? A lecture series or a quiz competition or a storytelling session or a go fish session, film screening, drawing, role play, writing competition, makerspace debate, and you can come up with any new ideas to promote the knowledge sharing or reading related activities. Okay, and you have to submit this report into our another Google form that we capture very basic information about the event. And these are some of the activities being conducted by various NDLA clubs. And now we have also looked at incentivizing the best performing NDLA clubs at the district, state and national level, depending on the number of registered and active users, how many reading related activities conducted, and number of participants in the activities. And also now we have come up with something called a new initiative called Reading Olympiad. So we conducted a first Reading Olympiad for Coimbatore district, and we got a very good response. So over 300 students participated from around 50 institutions in from Coimbatore. And now we are planning to scale up this across all the districts of Tamil Nadu. and at the national state level and to other state also. Now we have also negotiated with the Bangalore University for conducting a state level reading Olympiad for Karnataka also. So these are my basic contact details. So my name is Vignesh and my email ID is vignesh@ndl.gov.in. And this is my personal email ID, vigneshjnu@gmail.com. And here is my mobile number. It's 9999654458. Okay. So for any information related to NDLI, like NDLI club, you can kindly contact me. For bulk registration, you can contact my colleague, Mr. Rajendra Singh. His email ID is ndl-support@iitkgp.ac.in and his personal email ID is rajendra.singh1310@gmail.com and his mobile number is 8197564857. Okay, so I encourage, I request all of you to go back to your own institution and conduct an awareness session about NDLI. And if you want us to also conduct a webinar for them, we would be happy to conduct. And I have already had a discussion with Dr. Hariharan to conduct an workshop, one-day workshop about NDLI and various aspects of NDLI club. Maybe after this, the current situation is getting better, and we will get back to you. And I would really encourage all of you to have seriously look at NDLI as a platform to share resources. And if you have any specific feedback, kindly send an email to me. Our team is very open. We are happy to listen to constructive criticisms and kindly give your feedback. We'd be happy to work on it and then we will get back to you. And with this, I complete my presentation. And I thank Dr. Hariharan and the entire Solis team for hosting us for this webinar. And now we can take questions. So kindly ask the questions using chat. So I'm happy to respond to your questions. Yes, I will share the presentation, but I want you to hope how many of you have registered for in the forms which I have shared. I will stop sharing my screen. Okay, so my sincere request to you is, I request you to people who have not registered on the Google form which we have shared, so kindly re-register because I may not be able to, there are about 100 participants in this group and I will not be able to take down all the details of you. So kindly go to the registration form URL, which I've put it on the chat now, and I'm putting it again. So kindly go to this registration page and then register. For people who have already registered, kindly do not register. So we have given an option for members of Solis members. So kindly click and then submit your basic details and then submit, register. So this is what we want. So only for registered users, I will be able to take out their details and then send the email with the follow-up presentation and some information about NDLI Club. Any question? Kindly.
You can share the link once again, sir. You can share the link so that they will.
Yeah, yeah. I have just entered the, put the URL again in the chat. Okay, there is a question from Mr. Ramasamy K. Can I deposit my own content in NDL? My institution doesn't have an IR. So currently we collaborate with institutions only. So anyways, you send me an email with the kind of collections you have. I hope they are all non-copyrighted resources. If they are non-copyrighted and they are open source resources, then we would be considering it. And you have to send me an email. I will connect you with a corresponding team to take it forward.
Please share the link, sir.
Yeah, I have already shared, sir. I'm sharing it again.
Okay. think you open and show it because it's not visible, I think.
Okay. So can you all stop for a minute in entering the chat? So I'm just going to put the chat, this URL for registration. So kindly don't chat now. Just wait for a minute. I'm just entering, putting the URL for registration. So don't put any chat message for next 1 minute. So all of you who have not registered on this Google form, kindly register so that I can capture your details and send your a follow-up email. And I also request you to, some of you, if you can take some screenshot and kindly send it to my email ID. Once Anna NFT gets reopened, we will talk about NDLA Club, sir. Okay. Okay. Any questions, any specific questions from anyone? If there are no further questions, so may I request Dr. Hariharan to take it forward. So just a moment, sir. Just Dr. Hariharan, just wait for a moment. Your mic is mute.
So thank you, sir, for your excellent presentation. Now the participant might have come to know the all the futures of the NDLI. Definitely, we'll take it forward in the coming days after the corona is over. We'll organize a series of program many parts of the country along with Chalice and NDLI. Maybe along with also the collaborative with the institution in the various regions. So now if anybody who would like to ask a question, maybe put in the chat box. Otherwise, we'll I will ask Dr. Dominic, sir, you are available? Hello?
Sir, you may have to unmute his mic.
Okay, okay. So if you can, Dr. Dominic will be there, sir. Maybe you can unmute his mic.
Yeah, yeah. What I will do is I will unmute all. So what you can do is you can ask Dr. Dominic to unmute his mic and then speak. Okay, there is a question from Ms. Ponsilvi. There has any subscription to pay for There is no subscription fee involved for NDLI. And there is Ms. Priyanka Patacharji. Kindly register on the URL which I have. I'm just putting it on your personal chat. So kindly register here. We don't. We can't capture all the chat messages here. Yes, Dr. L. Radha, our team is working on it and we will resolve all the issues. Yes, so Ms. Ponsilvi, 75% of our resources are full text and they are all free to use. Okay, Dr. Hariharan.
Yes, sir.
So I think there is one question from Santosh Kumar Gori. Registration is mandatory to access NDLI. Yes, one-time registration is mandatory, Mr. Santosh. If you have to download any resource, you have to get yourself registered, then only you will be able to access the resources.
Yes, sir. Please kindly unmute the Dr. Dominic's mic. Sir Dominic, sir, please.
Okay. So wait. I have unmuted his mic.
Oh, 1 minute. You unmuted?
Wait, sir. I think it's taking time.
Okay.
So, Dr. Dominic, can you unmute it?
Yes. Now. Sir, don't proceed. Okay. Please proceed, sir. Kindly brief the report. The
can I proceed?
The meeting. Okay.
So thank you very much, and it was really a wonderful session on NDLI. The presentation was started by the introduction by Dr. Hariharan, the founder president of SALIS. He has given a very good introduction about this, and also he has introduced the today's speaker, Dr. Vignesh, with regarding to this NDLI awareness program. And Dr. Vignesh has started his presentation introduction with the NDIL, and he was explaining about how NDIL was started, and it was way back in 2016. The objectives of NDIL has been framed, and how these objectives have been achieved the years by, and the main key objectives also he has explained that take the NDIL to reach to all over India. And more than 22 lakhs of users resources were being available in the NDL at the time. And now it has become 4.7 crore resources. It has been increased. And it is the main objective is one library for throughout India that he was explaining. In that only he was telling about 4.7 crore resources. Now the NDL has been reached. The main prospects of NDL he has explained, and also how the metadata are arranged and used, and how it is the heart of the NDL, it has been explained by him. And also he has explained about the use model, how it is used NDL for the and he has explained about the models that is in the NDL. And also the content, how the content has been arranged, and also top 20 content contributes to the NDL that he has been also explained. And also he has explained the range of content, how far it has been included in NDL, which it has been satisfying all the users who use the NDL. Also he is telling how the NDL we can access search and full text, how it can be, how the filter option are working in the NDL. And also he has given NDL mobile app, how it can be installed and how we can use it. And also he has given time for us to do this as practically, and it was really a wonderful thing. And also he was explaining about the keyword search and for different types of people, how they can search and filter and take the result from this. And lastly he has explained about the big picture of the NDL, how it has been structured, and also NDL club and the support to start the NDL club, and also the support the NDL club from various institution. And lastly the registration process, bulk registration and individual registration. And also he compared in the beginning that Google versus NDL, that was very nice, and totally his presentation was indeed very good. So the credit goes to him, and as a librarians, we will make use of this NDL very much. So thank you very much, sir. Your presentation is good. Back to Dr. Hariharan, sir.
So thank you very much, Dr. Dominic. Dr. Dominic actually is the chief librarian of the Carnegie University and our past president, and currently is advisor to SALIS. Thank you for Dr. Dominic, sir, for your brief reporting. And now actually the participants, we request that we will take the what you call NDLI and the service of the club to the grassroots level, and will provide all the required service to the user. That is objective of the program. And now I request Dr. Mandrachal, are you here, or Karan Raghavan, to propose a vote of thanks?
We need to unmute their mic. So I don't know where.
Yes, sir. Hello?
Just give me a moment, sir. I can't see.
Karan Raghavan, Mandrachal, who is going? Please. Sir, you can unmute the mic, Mandrachalam and Karani Raghavan, and
just give me a moment. So, doctor, so whoever, they can unmute their mic and then they can speak, sir. Is this Mr. Babu? So, Harigaran, sir.
1 minute, sir. Mandrachalam, are you here or? Hello? Yes, yes.
Yeah, I have got him.
Please. Now, you propose what of thanks? He is our former general secretary and advisor to sir.
Good afternoon to 1.5% for this webinar technology on NDLI awareness session, organized jointly by SALIS and NDLI. First, I would like to thank Mr. Vignesh Swarnamohan for accepting our invitation to present about the NDLI features and search features, mobile app, and all other resource categories, etc. Thank you, sir, for your valuable spending.
So, okay, so actually, dear participant, once again, on behalf of Intelli and Sally, we thank you. And I request all of you to join our next program that is coming 23rd Thursday. The topic is library services during a crisis, support services to the student. The speaker is Dr. Kumaresan from New Zealand. He'll be addressing. Then we are also planning to organize one more workshop on how to prepare libraries for the NAC and the NPA. And suppose, sir, are you planning to give any participant certificate? Is there any?
So I'm going to send them a follow-up email that will mention them their participation, because there are about 100 people, and currently generating the certificate is difficult. So they can use that email as their like letter for participation.
Yes.
For that, they have to register in the URL which I've given. So I'm going to give it again, once again. So kindly, whoever has not registered for this webinar, kindly register in this URL which I've put it just now. Kindly register yourself so that I can send you a follow-up come participation email that will be useful for you in future.
Yes, sir. Suppose even SALIS also maybe can arrange certificate. Suppose if you are registered a member of SALIS app, and we can give you a certificate also. Automatically you can log into SALIS app and get the certificate downloaded. But only the PC, because some of the members or names are given like the CDE94E, then 11Q.com, then IWD, because that name you are given with registering. Better you can pick up some names we could be able to identify, because we also have a list of registered participants, more than 130-140 people. But it's very difficult to know. See, for example, CCOE91AE, some name is there. So we may not be able to know who is there. So if you all if your name is not visible, correct name, maybe you can forward your name and this thing, then we may be able to give the certificate. But provided if you have a registered users of SALIS app, because the participant certificate is linked to the SALIS app. Otherwise, we cannot give. Otherwise, we can take what you call mail from Dr. Vignesh.
Yeah, so, okay, so sir. I will share the list of participants to you separately. Yeah. So okay, I once again thank you, Dr. Harigaran, and all the SALIS members. And all the participants, thanks for participating. Thank you so much. Bye.
Okay. Thank you very much. Then we will close the session.
Sure.
We thank once again the research person, all the participants. Thank you all. Thank you. Bye bye. Thank you all. We'll meet in the next webinar. Take NTLA forward to your.